So it is a requested tutorial on motion graphics. Actually, in the last video of the receive commented that when I will tell you about motion graphics. So here it is. We will make this in simple 3 steps. So let's get started. Hello internet, what's going on? This is Sean Kareem and you're watching ZCreate. So let's start with making a new composition. I don't want to save it, so let's build a new comp. Name it anything. By the way, you can check my preset as well. Now step 1, animating the text. Just right click here and choose a solid. I told you solid is for background, so name it anything. I'm naming it BG. Go to effects and presets and choose gradient ramp from here. You can write just ramp or gradient, you will see. Now choose 2 colors of your choice. I'm choosing, I guess this will be okay. Either you can change the direction of colors by holding these 2 anchor points and drag them anywhere you want. I'm putting this here. This looks cool to me. Now choose a text. For that, choose a text layer and write anything. I'm writing motion graphics. Let's change the color of this. White would be okay, I guess. Okay, now we have a text. Now we have to animate this, so click here, go to transform properties or just hit S for the scale. I want it to scale in 1 second. Let's hit this clock here and make this 150. Now you will see when we proceed along the timeline, you will see that it's decreasing its size from 150 to 100. Now I want it to rotate a bit more. Press R on the keyboard, put a keyframe here. By the way, you guys should know how to put a keyframe. I told you in the last video. If you haven't watched it yet, you will find it here in the card up there. So now the text is animating. Now choose these keyframes and easy ease them by pressing F9 or just right click and easy ease them. This is a graph editor. This is a speed graph. If you hold these anchor points and drag this down here, you will see now the speed of graph and the speed of your text animation is changed. It's faster in starting and then slowed down, which is so smooth. Now do same with rotation. Press F9 or just right click easy ease. Go to graph editor, drag their points. You will see the graph is this shape right now. Now it's of this shape. Our text is animated. So we go to step 2, adding these motion graphics around the text. Just right click here and choose the shape layer. Now choose any shape. I'm choosing a rectangle for now. I want this rectangle to animate and then ellipse. So as I told you, to animate a shape layer, you just have to do trim path. Click here and go to trim path, just hit this and you will see this arrow. Click this and go to trim path, and from trim path you will see these 3 properties, start and offset. Just focus here. As I'm decreasing the percentage of end, the rectangle is animating itself. Likewise with start, but from different direction. So you can play as you want. Now I want it to animate, so just follow me here. I'm gonna put a keyframe on end and decrease it by 0 from starting, and then by 15 frames I want it to animate fully, by 100% I guess. And then I go back to like 5 frames and put a keyframe on start. Just follow me here, and around 20-25 frames I made this like 100. Now see, our rectangle is animating like this. Cool, isn't it? You can animate any shape from trim path. Now you can drag these keyframes along the timeline as you want. Now the text would be animated a little bit slow. Now you can easy ease them by pressing F9 on the keyboard. Go to graph editor, drag these anchor points of graph like this, same with them. I assume that now you guys should know how to animate anything and how to easy is something. So I'm gonna speak the things a little bit now. In the case of easy is, so choose another shape layer and let's make a circle now. So for that I'm gonna choose ellipse tool and I want it to start from 1 second. So made a circle. You can adjust the position later on, but make sure it's a circle. By if you press shift, a perfect circle will form. By the way, you can change the width of ellipse by stroke. I'm putting 35 for now. Follow me here and see, you will see this ellipse property, and in ellipse properties you will see stroke. Click on this and you will see this line cap portion where it is butt joint. From butt joint, put it as round cap. And now go to add and trim path and do the same as we did before. Put a keyframe on end and start as you like, animate as you like, and let's speed up things now. Easy is them, as I told you. Drag these keyframes around 2 seconds. So our animation is a bit slow right now, which is cool, I guess. Now easy is them by pressing F9. By the way, I put the round cap because you see these edges are round now, while in the back, in the case of rectangle, the edges are sharp. This is the advantage of putting round cap. Now likewise, make couple of layers in that way, apply the trim path property and make as many motion graphics as you want. Right now I'm just gonna duplicate it and resize it, put this stroke a bit lesser, and I want it to look a bit random than the previous circle. So for that, just hit R on the keyboard while on your circle too, and you will see the rotation properties, or you can just go to the transform and from there you can find this rotation property as well. And just hit R and change this direction a bit. Now you will see that both circles starts at the same time but from different direction and ends at different direction. Likewise, you can make as many circles as you want. I'm gonna duplicate another one and let's resize it. It's all on your choice. The method is to understand how to animate an object, which I have told you. Just pull trim path, play with start and end. Now see this, that would be fine, I guess. Adjust these shape layers in your timeline according to your will, like when you want them to be started. So at first you see our rectangle animate and then our circles. So for the next step, it's just optionally, either you can follow the next step or you can leave. But the next step is for to add the motion graphics for background, which is something different. So follow me here. So for that, I told you we can make multiple composition at a time, because if we work in single composition, it will be a quite messier than here. So I'm gonna make another composition of motion graphics. Choose a shape layer and let's make a circle, a smaller one. Animate this, as I told you, trim path properties, start and put a keyframe on end. Decrease it by 0, then go to 15 or maybe 10 frames is this time. Put it 100, and likewise with start, but start keyframe should start after the keyframe of end. So just follow me here, you will see. By the way, I would recommend you if you practice this with me. So bring the keyframes down a bit like this, so they are more into the shape now. And likewise, easy is them by selecting all the keyframes, go to graph editor and drag these anchor points. Now make a couple of duplicates of the shape layer and put them anywhere else as you want. You will see this. Now I want them to look a bit random, so for that just rotate them a bit or scale down them, or you can increase and decrease the stroke property from up there. Or you can play with the timeline and change the timing when they start. You can also make them to look a bit random. See. Now, apart from the shape layers, I want to tell you some other way to transform and animating a motion graphics. Let's go to 0 second and make another shape layer. This time we are going to select pen tool and just draw anything like shape. I'm not really good with pen tools anyway, so I'm just gonna draw like this, I guess. We have our shape layer because we have a stroke property on. Now go to trim path, again same as usual, and play with your start and end properties. You can also play with offset. Offset, if you play keyframe on offset, you will see that this will do something like this. You see this animating part, it's moving all the way from where you want it to. Just follow me right here, and now I want it to be 100%. See, a line is animating like this. You can make couple of lines like this and easy is all of them, or just leave them as you want. So now what you can do is you can just go back to your main composition again and drag down your motion graphic composition from right here like this, and you will see it's here. Now see, everything you did there is here too. So this is all about motion graphics. If you want to learn anything else, you can just comment down below and I will give a tutorial on it.
I want you to tell me that on what topic or on what stuff I should give you the second tutorial here. We can start to basics if you want, or we can go to some complicated stuff and some really cool stuff too. So it's all your call. Comment down below, everyone. Share this video, share this channel with everyone. Keep supporting, keep loving, and thank you everyone for everything. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button here down below, and just share this video with everyone. Tell me what you want to be learned in next tutorial. We can go for it, doesn't matter if it's complicated. Or comment down below whether you like it or not. Any queries, anything, comment down below, I will answer. Subscribe this channel, share this channel, and take care, stay safe, stay home. See you soon.